little kids at McDonald's, eating Happy Meals. A perfect day in paradise, all the parents agree. Another round of chocolate shakes, more onion rings and French fries. Processed sugar and deep fried fat, and lots of festive liquid dye. The clerk's behind the counter, singing four-part harmony. The fluorescent bulbs flicker on and off, the plastic clown smiles balefully. The front door opens and a man comes in, silhouetted by the midday sun. Dressed in thrift store combat fatigues, in his hands a semi-automatic gun. He's had a real hard life, he never ever really had a break. Pushed down from the day he was born, but today he's finally gonna make the grade. He's going to pay them all back, all the jerks for whom he's ever worked, his nagging wife and the bill collectors. It's time to hurt like he's been hurt. The bullets fly, the kids all die, his lost manhood is now restored. He lights a post-coital cigarette, drops a spent match on the floor. The president is outraged, stern measures he advocates. No more semi-automatic guns, he says, unless of course they're American made. His handlers cheer heartily, another bold political stand. The consequences of his words resound, but nobody really gives a damn. 'Cause when the NRA comes calling up on Capitol Hill, all the politicians bend over their desks and start to grunt and squeal. A climax of $100 bills leaves everyone with a contented glow. Later on, at the press conference, they'll denounce the evils of gun control. They say we gotta keep this country strong and free. It's a bastion of liberty. Freedom comes from the barrel of a gun, Mr. Voter, so why don't you buy yourself one? At your local sporting goods store, hold the gun in your clammy hand, and I'll make you feel so good, better than any woman can. Join the hundreds of thousands of other brainwashed idiots who can quote the Second Amendment without understanding a word of it. Explain it to the dead pregnant woman, victim of a drive-by shooting. Explain it to the two dead kids enacting scenes from their favorite Rambo movie. Explain it to the Canadian women. Explain it to all the postal workers. Explain it to their families and friends. Explain it to yourself if you can. If you belong to the NRA, I suggest you go screw yourself. The barrel of your gun should fit in either your anus or your mouth. May God save the NRA. May God save the NRA. May God save the NRA.